Hey there, YouTube. My name is Julian Pesnica for Not a Picture. In this tutorial, we'll create a particle simulation often seen in branding and advertisements. Let's have a look at the results first. For this technique, we'll use Blender's geometry nodes and the simulation zone to animate the particles physically plausible, and with additional leads to guide the particles in a certain way. At first, we need the logo or text. For now, we use the word round. Bold fonts are preferable because later we'll split the solid elements into fractions with different colors. Bigger areas will give us more space to emphasize these elements. And now the text needs a little bit depth. After that, the text will be converted to a mesh. Now we'll go into the GeoNodes area, create a new GeoNode setup and add a mesh to volume node, and increase its density so the volume reassembles the original form. Then add the distribute points in volume node, which scatters points in the volume, and here we'll increase the density as well. From there on, we decrease the particle scaling with the setpoint radius node. Now we have the fundamental setup for the particle simulation. Next, we'll create the different shapes and the split points for each letter. To change the form, we'll add a set position node and add a noise texture to the set positions node offset input. Then we subtract each vector value by 0.5 to recenter the particles. From there on, we add the position and a vector math node to the vector input to change the mapping of the noise texture. After that, we change the z-axis scaling with the vector math modulo operator. Now, each element is separated into multiple forms. To heighten this effect, we lower the noise scale. Now the elements are bigger and clearly defined. Let's increase the particle count and lower the size. Now we'll multiply the displacement with the normal noise Z level. And with that, we get an even clearer separation. After that, we change the subtract node's value to center the text again. And now the fun begins. The prior steps were the initial part. Now we'll animate the particles. The key points to consider will be the particle's initial force by a noise texture, the attraction of each particle based on the distance of each other, and the collision and the guidance by a non-visible object for the main movement. First, we add the simulation zone to our node tree. Then we add the aforementioned initial force by adding a set position node. Then we add a noise texture to the offset. At first, the particles change, but they disappear after one frame. And to fix that, we have to center the animation again by subtracting 0.5 on each axis by a vector math node. Then we'll scale the noise pattern strength down, so the effect is not that transformable. The next step will be the attraction of each particle to the next based on the distance. The first node will be the merge by distance node. This node merges two particles based on a given distance threshold. So this node will calculate a new particle that will be centered across the former merged particles. So then we'll compare the new merged particle's position to the original particle's position with geometry proximity node. And then it is important to set the mode from faces to point. Then we add a vector math subtract node and subtract the original position to the proximity. Then we add a scale node to manipulate the effectiveness of the attraction. After that, we add a switch node, which is triggered by the distance of the geometry proximity node. So if the distance is zero, that means that the particles were on top of each other, the vector will switch to zero and the attraction movement will stop. This will eliminate unwanted behavior when the particles have the same position. The switched node output then goes into the offset of the set position node, and then the distance will change the radius attraction force. The scale factor controls the speed of the particle's movement. For this purpose, the scale has to be negative, otherwise it should result in the opposite effect. Now here you can see the particles attracting each other, and multiple will combine into one. For the next part, we'll use the same method as for the attraction. First, we'll add a merge by distance node. a geo proximetry node, and subtract the particle's original position from the merged position. Then the resulting vector will be normalized and then scaled down. This node setup will be merged into one group. The distance and the scale will be connected as a group input, so it could be changed in the main node tree easily. Then we'll duplicate the group several times to get a more precise and less jittery collision calculation. Then the groups will be merged into another group and the distance and scale values will be connected as a group input as well. Now this group can be duplicated 3 times. Now we add 2 value nodes for the distance and scale. Oh, and one thing to mention, the merge by distance node has to be set to point, or else the collision wouldn't work. And now we set the distance and scale to values, which lets the simulation look plausible. In the next chapter, we create a rail system that the particles follow. Here we add a curve into the scene. Now let's edit its shape, so it starts next to the text and extends out into the scene. Then we'll sample the position with a sample curve over time with the scene time node. We connect the sample's position and its rotation along the tangent of the curve to a transform geometry node. This node will change the position and rotation of the icosphere, which will be the lead for the particles. Then we'll add a geometry proximetry node, set its mode to points, and connect the position node to the source position. Then we add a vector math subtract node and subtract the source position by the icosphere's position. And then we'll scale the amount by a vector math scale node. Now we have a basic lead system that we combine into the simulation. We add the set position node and connect the node setup to the offset input. And now for the setup, we make the icosphere here visible. Therefore, we add a join mesh node and add the icosphere to it as well. And now the icosphere starts at the top of the curve, which we don't want. So we have to change the curve's direction under segments and switch directions. Now let's see. The particles fly in the opposite direction, so we have to change the scale to negative value to change the direction. Then we add a quasi-effector to change the behavior of the particles. Let's add a vector math scale node and separate the Z position, because the Z transformation is in this particular case prominent. And we add a math node with the absolute operator to only get the positive values. And then we divide the Z values so the particles are more scattered around the scene. Then we add another scale node, which gets the proximetry node's distance as its scale value. The distance will be calculated by the power of -1, which will further scatter the particles around. The next step is about the materials. Our goal is to color the particles based on the Z height, so the lower ones should have a different color tone than the top ones. So we need to save the particles' position. Therefore, we add a store named attribute node before the simulation starts. Then we add a position node and separate its vector coordinates. We add a math node to control the values and connect the math node's output to the value input of the attribute node. After that, we give the attribute a name. In the shader editor, we create a new material and link the created material with the GeoNode system by adding the set material node to the end of the node tree and selecting the newly created shader. Going into render view with cycles, we can see the material. The scene doesn't have any significant light source, so we add a sunlight to it. Then in the shader editor, we add the attribute node to get the Z height of each particle. Then we type in the same name we chose in the store named attribute node beforehand. Now we add a color ramp in which we can set the color for the Z values. The left side controls the lower Z positions and the right the higher. The map range node gives us more control over the input and output values. After that, we can add a math node to raise the values. Then we raise the saved Z value by 1, and now we see the different colors. Let's change them to more colorful tones and change the input height and the mapping of the colors. In the next step, we randomize the particle sizes. For that, we go back to the setPointRadius node and add a noise texture. Add a math node and set it to divide. Now let's see which size fits. And a division by 156 should fit. Okay, so let's change a few values to alter the appearance. For example, let's change the scale for the initial force to a lesser value. And there we have it. Thank you for watching, and if you are interested, check out our video about temporal denoising. Cheers.